Okay, good morning everyone. In the previous class, we have studied about the carbamates compounds and what are how to write the structure and all. So today we shall study how to write the electron dot structure. So as you all know, while writing the electron dot structure, some things we have to keep it in our mind. So before going to that one, let us see here which are the functional groups. In the last class also we have studied a little bit about the functional groups. So the functional groups mainly are alcoholic group, aldehyde group, carboxylic group, ketone group and amino group. So here alcoholic group it is designated by OH or O, single bond H. Aldehyde group can be written as CH4, that is C double bond OH. Carboxylic group it is can be written as the C double bond O OH. Ketone group it is just C double bond O. Amino group it is NH2. Now considering these functional group, now let us learn how to write the functional group, basic structure, skeletal structure and electron dot structure. Because this electron dot structure it is very important when concerned with the examination. In the view of your examination, this writing electron dot structure is very important. So the main thing is you will get confused how to write the electron dot structure. But then trust me, it is very easy, it's very easy. The only thing is you have to follow certain rules and regulation. If you follow that one, definitely it is very easy. So now let us study here how to write the electron dot structure. So one example I will take here, butane. So here buta means 4 carbon, ane, the suffix ane refers to the saturated hydrocarbon. So now if they ask you write electron dot structure for butane, suddenly directly you cannot go for writing the electron dot structure. Before that you have to write the basic structure, skeletal structure, based on that you can write on the electron dot structure. So butane, 4 carbon compound, it is a 4 carbon compound and with the saturated it is single bond, all the CC bond it is single bond, and for this we have to write the hydrogen. So the molecular formula of butane is, we have to count the how many carbon are there and how many hydrogen are there. So the structure, the molecular formula it becomes a C4, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So the molecular formula is C4H10. So after writing this molecular formula, basic structure or the skeletal structure, based on that we can write down the electron dot structure. So when writing the electron dot structure, you have to represent in the form of ring structure. So when the ring structure in that one, only you have to write down the valence electron, not the completed shell electron. So this is the most important thing. You have to keep it in your mind while writing the electron dot structure. That is, only you have to write the represent the valence electron, not the completed shell electron. So for that we have to know what is the valence electrons, what is the configuration. So let us write the configuration for carbon. It is C6 upon 12, that is 1s2, 2s2 and 2p2. And hydrogen, it is 1h upon 1, that is only 1s1. So this is the completed shell and this is the valence shell. That is, it has got 4 valence electrons and hydrogen has got only 1 lone electron, its valence also 1 and valence electron also it is 1. So by knowing the valence electron, it is very easy to write the dot structure. Now just follow me how to write the dot structure. So here first you have to write down the main parent hydrocarbon, that is the main chain, that is mainly formed by the carbon. So here 4 carbon are there, that's why you have to draw 4 circles. So here 1 circle, 2, 3 and 4. So here 4 carbon I have represented by 4 ring structures here. So 1 ring represents the 1 carbon. And now for this carbon, 3 hydrogen are there. That's why you have to draw 3 ring structures for 1 carbon. So here I draw here. This is the 1 hydrogen, 2nd hydrogen and 3rd hydrogen. Now for the 2nd carbon, 2 hydrogens are there. That's why for the 2nd ring structure, you have to draw here 1 ring, here 1 ring. Again for the 3rd carbon, the same thing. that is two rings. Again for the fourth carbon, three hydrogen atoms are there. That's why you have to draw three circles. Now after doing so, this is the make of basic formation what we have done in our electron dot structure. So after writing this structure, now the second step is you have to represent the bonds. So here one CC bond is there and one CH bond is there. So already I have told that one single covalent bond refers to one shared pair of electron. So one covalent bond, it is nothing but two electron. One electron is shared by carbon, another electron is shared by the hydrogen. And here also CC bond, this also the first carbon is sharing one electron and the second carbon also sharing one electron. So 1 plus 1, 2 electron, nothing but one pair of electron. So one pair of electron, it is represented by one covalent bond. So now this one covalent bond can be represented by two dots. That is, two dots are nothing but the two electron. So in this first carbon, let us now mention this one. This is carbon and this is the hydrogen. Now in this CC bond, that is one single covalent bond, it is sharing two electrons. That's why we have to represent here two electrons. So here one electron from carbon, another electron from hydrogen. See here this CH bond, here also CH, we are representing one covalent bond. That's why here two electron, one dot, one into one, I have put just in order to differentiate which is sharing which electron. So the dot refers to the electron shared by the carbon, into one refers to the X, refers to the electron shared by the hydrogen. Again here also one electron is shared by the carbon, another by the hydrogen. Again here one by the carbon, another by the hydrogen. The same thing we have to write here also, one dot and one into one, in order to show that one electron it is shared by carbon, another electron it is shared by the hydrogen. So after this one, next here the carbon, now CC bond. So carbon also is sharing one electron, this carbon also is sharing electron. That's why I have shown here two dots. Here also two dots and here also two dots. Now this carbon, now just we can see now whether the octane configuration it has completed or not. So as you know, the main thing why the elements will undergo chemical bonding. Chemical bonding it will occur in order to attain the electronic configuration, octane configuration. So now let us check here whether that rule completing the octane configuration it has satisfied or not. Let us see here. So this hydrogen it has got. So just if we consider this hydrogen, it has completed two electrons. So hydrogen it has got one electron and it requires only one electron in order to complete the duplet configuration. So since it has got only one shell, and the first shell it has got s orbital, and s orbital's maximum occupying capacity is 2 electrons. So the 2 electrons it has got satisfied by combining, by sharing the electrons with the carbon. Now again here also 2 electrons. So if we check this structure, all the hydrogen atoms it has completed the duplet configuration, electronic configuration, by sharing the electrons with the carbon. Now let us see here whether carbon has satisfied the octane configuration. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So this carbon it has completed octane configuration. That is the main principle why the carbon or any other element will enter into the chemical bond formation. So the second carbon also 2, 4, 6, 8 electrons it has satisfied. Here also 2, 4, 6, 8 electron. So total it is satisfied. So this is how we have to follow step by step in order to write down the electronic configuration. Dear children, did you feel any difficulty writing the configuration? Not at all. So if you follow these steps, when they give any compound, first you write down the molecular formula. Otherwise, if you don't know how to write the directly molecular formula, go for the structure. In order to write the structure, follow the words, prefix and suffix. Butane, 4 carbon, write down the 4 carbon. Suffix is A, A means saturated hydrocarbon. That is all the CC bond, it will be single bond. Write down the single bond. and then we have to satisfy the hydrogen. So when you write the basic structure, then you can follow, then you have to write down the electron configuration, make out how many valence electrons it has got and what is the valency, and directly can go for the electron dot structure. And for this electron dot structure, let us see how we can write the functional group. So here I have shown you the main five types of functional group: alcoholic group, aldehydic group, carboxylic, ketone and amino. And here I have shown how to write the expanded form of the functional group. Now I will take this carboxylic group and let us see how it will change the butane compound. So for this butane, when it combines with the functional group, in the last class only I had told this functional group, it is not an addition reaction, it is a substitution reaction. So in this substitution, one hydrogen, it will get replaced by the one functional group. Now let us see how it will get a change here. So one hydrogen, it will get replaced by the functional group. So by writing the functional group, one important thing you have to keep it in the mind. This butane, when it combines with the carboxylic group, that is functional group, the name it will get changed into butanoic acid, because here buta, that is the first three letters of compound and the last two letters of the functional group you have to combine. So for carboxylic acid, we will write the suffix oic. So buta plus oic, it will become butanoic acid. So the compound, it will become butanoic acid. So now let us see here how the butanoic acid, how to write the electron dot structure for the butanoic acid. So for this one, first we have to write down the electron dot structure. For that we have to write down the basic structure. So in butanoic acid, again here only four carbon compound, it is made up of only four carbon compound. Butane refers to the four carbon. So for this four carbon only, we have to write the functional group. So for the fourth carbon, we have to write it for the functional group. So here four carbon we have written, and for the last we have to write the functional group. C double bond O OH. So because carboxylic group, carboxylic compound, it is nothing but the C double bond O OH. So I have written here C double bond O OH. That is three hydrogen, it will get replaced by the functional group. So for the same carbon, now the compound it will become 4 carbon buta, functional group it is carboxylic, that's why it is known as oic acid. That is, it will become butanoic acid. Now for this we shall write down the electron dot structure. Again here, first we have to follow 4 carbon, that is 4 ring structure you have to write down. Here 4 carbon is there, that's why 4 ring structure. And for the first carbon, 3 hydrogen are there. Now let us write here 3 hydrogen. Again for the second carbon, 2 hydrogen are there. That's why you have to write 2 ring structure. For the third carbon, only 2 ring structures are there. That is 2 hydrogen. And for the fourth carbon, you have to write the oxygen. That is here 1 ring. And here OH, you can write O and H. Now we shall name these rings: carbon, 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 carbon. These are all hydrogen. And this is oxygen, and this is oxygen and hydrogen. So these are the different elements that are combined with the carbon. Now let us balance the electrons here. So one electron it is donated by the carbon, and another electron it is donated by the hydrogen. It is shared by the hydrogen. So these two carbon-carbon, this also carbon-carbon, carbon-carbon, and here carbon and oxygen. Here also carbon and oxygen. Here oxygen and hydrogen. So here, see double bond O have written, already have told, one single covalent bond refers to one pair of electron. But here we have written two bonds refers to two pairs of electron. That's why we have written here two pairs of electron. electron that is shared by carbon and oxygen. So now let us see here whether all the octet configuration it has completed or not. So here hydrogen, all the hydrogen it has shared 2 electron, and carbon, this carbon it has got 2, 4, 6, 8 electron. Here also 8 electron, here also 8 electron, here also 8 electron. Here oxygen it has got 4. As you know, oxygen its electronic configuration, oxygen its atomic number is 8, atomic mass number is 16. So if you write the configuration, it becomes 1s2, 2s2, 2p, 4. That is a 2 plus 2, 4 plus 4, 8 electron. So if we bifurcate, here it will become 6 electron, 6 valence electron. So already I have told one basic rule you have to follow is you have to mention, you have to represent the valence electron, 6 electron. So here already 4 electrons are there, another 2 electrons here you have to show. So here 2 electrons it has shared with the carbon. So 2 electron, still 4 electrons it has got. 1, 2, 3, 4. So this oxygen also 2 electrons it has shared. Now see, 4 electrons it is remaining. Now if you count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, octet configuration completed. This oxygen also 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, octet configuration completed. So this is how you have to write the electron dot structure. So children, I'll give an assignment for you. Write down the, try to write down the electronic configuration for pentanol. So all gives here aldehyde. So you have to show the aldehyde inside the pentanol. Penta 5 carbon, for that we have to show the aldehyde group CH4. And then ethamamine. So here ethyl means 2 carbon, amine means here NH2 group. So try to write down the dot structure for these two compounds. So hope you all understood, enjoyed. Okay children, have a good day. Next, in the next class we shall meet you in next chapter with more and more information just for you. Have a good day.